Clifton plays it ahead for Hathaway. Clifton was going to the net unmarked, but Hathaway couldn't get the pass around. Mata, who got rocked by Clifton in the corner. They both get back to their feet, and the pass comes to Mata, and he has room to skate.
And he just got smoked.
Faceoff win for the Bruins. McAvoy right down the lane, and he rings it off the crossbar. And that one is out of play. I think that one went completely over the netting. This is turned over. Here's a chance for Valeno on a breakaway. Valeno in alone on Swayman, and it was knocked off his stick by a diving Carlo. And Swayman was able to adjust and stop it, but shaken up was Carlo as he went slamming into the end wall.
Yeah, Carlo looks okay. That off-speed shot was a tricky one for Swayman.
It's Berggren and Zadina. Got Osterley across too. They go to Zadina, just got a tip on it, and Swayman was there.
Beautiful outlet pass by Carlo, right on the tape.
Bergeron just got caught up high. One referee signaled that it was a follow-through. The other referee has signaled a high-sticking penalty. Well, Tyler Bertuzzi taking a peek up at the video board as they honor him, a Red Wing, for 7 seasons until 10 days ago. Second round pick in 2013, the Red Wings franchise, the only one he had ever known, and now he has a chance to go on a Stanley Cup run with the Boston Bruins. Boston has scored 4 power play goals on 10 chances this season against Detroit, and Ville Husso absolutely robbed Brad Marchand. Penalty here against the Boston Bruins. Nowhere to go with it. Changes the angle, rips it to the goal line. They tried to bump it in front for Larkin. Comes to Sider instead. Right side, Raymond. Raymond, Larkin turns, shoots, Swayman, they score! No! Yeah, it's in! It's Chiasson again! Swayman got across on the first one, and Chiasson put on the rebound.
It was a different setup yesterday afternoon when he scored off his right foot in the heel of his skate on a pass from David Perron.
Clifton hoists it down, bouncing puck right into the glove of Husso as he scooped it off the ice, and a little friendly poke from Frederick draws a couple of punches.
Yeah, not surprised by this. This is what the Boston Bruins did yesterday afternoon, and you can see Valeno was in the middle of it yesterday afternoon too. Boy, the Greer, Nosek, and Hathaway line.
Really plugged in nicely as he gets physical there and knocks Larkin down through the play offside. A lot of talk about the points for Morlov. There's a little bit of physical play as things are getting a little testy here on the second half of a back-to-back between these two teams.
Yep. And Mo Sider already had a gash under his chin and took stitches yesterday. And he and Clifton there, Suter and Bergeron. And then behind the play, keep your eye on Raymond.
They're inside the final 5 minutes of the first period as the Red Wings with a 1-0 lead on a power play goal, and they work it here. They got Perron in front. That shot blockered away by Swayman.
Wow, that was a good save. Puck went low to the stick side yesterday on that little break. There he went high.
Here's Perron, drags and shoots all in one motion, and Swayman had to be good again. And after the whistle, a crowd. Grizzlick to the front. That one sails on through everybody. Chiasson, look out, McAvoy had him lined up. Puck stays in the zone. Penalty here. The helmet of Chiasson was knocked off. And things are escalating. Oh! Big takedown along the ice. There are 4 players in the penalty box, 2 for each side. Osterley and Zarnik in for Detroit. McAvoy and Nosek are in the Boston Bruins penalty box. As the Bruins move ahead, Marchand into the zone. Curls, knocked down by Sider.
Brad Marchand's right beside me, and I think he's the one that's going to get called. He hopped off the boards. After the hit that Perron had on Bergeron, Marchand came in, and just a little cross-check in the forearm there of David Perron. Perron doesn't retaliate.
With a clean sheet of ice, but this is Boston shorthanded and a potential 2-on-1. Hathaway shot off the bar! Right off the elbow, over the shoulder of Husso. First period shots were just 8-4. For the Red Wings, as Mata's shot squeaked through the arm of Swayman, but rolled away from the net. Second period's where the Bruins took over yesterday. They've had the upper hand here so far, but that's off the bar from Kubalik. And it winds up in the netting, but that one right off the post. Pretty good company with them. Cale Makar, Quinn Hughes were also finalists that year for the Rookie of the Year award. And we have a penalty here.
t-shirt today.
Orlov, the new guy on the top unit, taking McAvoy's spot as he dishes off for Pastrnak. And this is stolen away by Sider. Mo Sider, shorthanded. The backhand, he scores! A shorthanded goal for Mo Sider gives the Boston Bruins a two-goal deficit to deal with here in Detroit.
Holy jumping, what a backhander. I mean, just to create a little bit of space after he steals it right here with a good stick on Pastrnak just to keep going. And now to get away, Pastrnak will skate and do his best to get back. But he goes to the backhand. Good toe curve right there. He hoists that back up over the glove and in the net, and just an all-world play by Mo Sider, last year's Rookie of the Year in the NHL. And boy, that will absolutely stall that power play that has just had some troubles. People may ask, why am I asking you? I'm on the other side of the ice. Yeah. You've got a better angle from your side.
Frederick turned it over in the middle of the ice. Wallman right on, and a save from Swayman. Carlo ahead for Greer, tapped it along, Nosek has Hathaway, got it to him, Hathaway save. Husso on the rebound, bounced away from Nosek, and he took a penalty. Just tapped along for Sider. Sider banks it back to Perron. Now Sider again, has Raymond across. Sider in the middle of the ice, drifting. Raymond from the dot, taking a look, snapped it off of Chiasson, but wide. He almost banked that in off Chiasson, it was tied up with Carlo. Sider to Raymond. Chiasson parked in front again. Larkin shoots, scores! Dylan Larkin on the power play, and the Wings are up 3.
Alex Tanguay and the coaching staff of the Red Wings had moved Larkin into that bumper position instead of the half boards, and it has paid dividends.
You don't say that too often in the NHL. Here's a play across for Krejci. Krejci shoots, save made, rebound fought for. There's Pastrnak to the net, save Husso, rebound alive. Husso outstretched. Can he get it covered up? He can. Krejci picks it up, takes a look. McAvoy at the top again. McAvoy, Krejci one timer. Husso looked behind him, but he has it in the pads. Hugh Suter, the undrafted 26-year-old from Switzerland, as Marchand's shot kicked away. They work Zadina, back-checking his Frederick to even the numbers. Zadina across, good connection with Valeto, and it shouldered up over the top of the net by Swayman.
What a save that was. That was labeled high short side on a quick wrist shot.
5 minutes to play here in the second period. It was 1-0 Detroit when it began. There's a goal! Just under the bar.
Look at this. Bar, post, out. And in one quick motion, Jeremy Swayman's not sure where that puck is. And it ends up right on the tape. Adam Ernie's got his eyes on it the whole way.
Krejci ahead for Zacha. Pavel Zacha, the drop. Pastrnak kept to the outside. Cross ice, Grizzlick shoots, scores! Pastrnak with the setup. It's Grizzlick who puts the Bruins on the board.
Yeah, Grizzlick followed that up on the right side as a lefty. And boy, in one quick motion, he snaps this to the far side after a good delay there by Pastrnak as he enters the zone. He went down the runway and on a quick little spin around play right here against Pastrnak. He tries to get away from him, rolls off, and then as he gets to free ice. You can see him hunched over right there and heading off the ice.
This one turned over and then shot in from center by Kubalik, and Swayman will hang on to it and then give Kubalik a little shove. Then Charlie Coyle, then McAvoy and Suter. And the linesman doing their best to separate everybody, but yeah. McAvoy.
And Swayman's trying to, you know, turn a negative into a positive right here. He's just trying to stir things up. He caught the puck. Kubalik came close. He kind of got his chest out there on him. Just a little bump. And his teammates came to his protection. Probably not seeing exactly what was going on. But again, you're trying to stir things up. You're trying to get something going here after the Red Wings have dominated the second period.
Here's Marchand with Orlov breaking. Marchand across. Bergeron to the net. Tip. Orlov at a backhand try. And Husso shot out that left leg. Bergeron in tight. That time it's knocked down and covered by Husso.
And just the opposite. The Boston Bruins have got their D fully activated.
Dylan Larkin back on the bench to start the third period for the Detroit Red Wings after he was shaken up towards the end of the second. Zero today. Down by three. Entering the third. Oh, this one bobbled by Husso. Oh, Nosek got a piece of him as he went by, but Husso was able to cover up.
And then Hathaway has got a good grab of Haig right there, but that puck was spinning. And so when it went off the blade of the stick of the goaltender Husso, it jumped away from him. His right skate and pad was hot, was really tight against the post.
Here's Pastrnak to Krejci in front, and he tapped it just wide. Greer steps away from the hit of Osterley. Now it's Greer down low, driving. Pocheck saved me. Rebound with the net empty, and it hit the outside of the cage. Husso scrambles back into position. Greer is shaken up behind the play. Meanwhile, it's Ernie into the Boston zone, and it's shouldered off by Swayman.
What a great poke check by Husso in tight.
And then Swayman, another tough stop. Then Zarnik to the front and tapped to the corner by Chiasson. Joe Valeno. So the slot for Valeno off his skate and wide. A.J. Greer has gone down the tunnel for Boston. Wallman across. Sider shot blocked in front by Swayman. And then Sider had his pocket picked. Here's DeBrusk in alone. Scores! Jake DeBrusk on a breakaway. And he brings the Bruins within two.
Little tweak of the lines pays off for Jim Montgomery and the Boston Bruins. And at the blue line, both Sider's trying to go to the backhand right there. And DeBrusk has other ideas. He's strong on the forehand. He fades away.
Clifton turns, looks, fed it to the front. Bergeron's tip was blocked. Now they stretch it out. It's Larkin on a breakaway. Dylan Larkin off the post. He put it through Swayman. He just altered the trajectory, and it had found the post and stayed out. Pastrnak double-teamed and lost it. Out of the zone, Berggren and Pastrnak tangled up as Grizzlick moves it for Zacha. Pastrnak right down the lane with a shot, and he scores! David Pastrnak, and it's a one-goal game.
You never know what he's going to do, and you've got to expect the unexpected. I thought he was going to pull up and play it to his right. He pulls up, he waits, he's got so much patience. It's incredible.
Now it's Kopp. He has Kubalik with him. DeBrusk on the back check, and it's McAvoy who interrupted the pass. McAvoy moves it along for Krejci. Wide open hockey here in Detroit. Frederick's shot stick to side. McAvoy back towards the net, and it's blocked. Kubalik had dropped the stick. He regathers. Marchand keeps it in the zone for Boston. Finds himself a little room. Went right through him.
He had him wide open. A tough pass and a tough one to read from that puck hitting his blade. And yeah, it looked to me like he was a little screened on the play. That's why there was a little delay in getting that blade to that pass.
Oh, that one hit the linesman, and Husso had to throw his body across the net to stop the shot from Bergeron.
Wow. He lost a little balance there. There was a lunging play.
Marchand was looking for either McAvoy or Bergeron. It was Bergeron. This one in the slot, and it was twisted away from the net by Sider. Grizzlick to the net. Bertuzzi a couple of chances, and Husso comes up big. And he'll go to the bench himself, but the puck stolen by Kopp. Sets up Kubalik, and a save from Swayman. Tried to dish it down and stolen away. A chance for Zadina. He's in alone. Zadina on the backhand, lifted it too tall.
Going on the backhand as a lefty and just trying to hoist it. He just overdid it.
Now it's Marchand across for Bergeron. Shut down by Mata. Carlo quickly over. Orlov. Marchand the shot. Husso's got it with the glove.
You have to let guys know if they've got time.
DeBrusk. Frederick off the apron. Bounced into the crease. And Husso's able to get the gloves down on it and draw the whistle. Like a timeout. Had his team gathered around him in the marker board out. Going over some late game plans. Here's Clifton to the net. And it's tipped wide by Zacha. Another open look at the side of the goal for Boston, and they could not convert. Wallman nearly buckled down. Here's Larkin coming out. He dives, can't clear it. Bouncing puck. Marchand just can't get there, and this one is out and back in. It's offside. Marchand shot the puck. Sider didn't like it.
No, he did not.
He felt Marchand knew that was offside, and he fired it anyway.
Yeah, and this faceoff's going to go all the way down, and the goaltender, Swayman's going to likely have to go back into the net if I'm correct on that call. And the Wings take exception to that late shot on goal by Marchand.
Forces it for Coyle. Zacha is replaced by Pastrnak. And he's back there, and it went off of him, and it'll crawl just wide. Oh, he didn't make contact with it. They're going to say icing here.
Wings are doing everything to get that puck out, and they can't.
The scrum for it. Krejci had it for a moment. McAvoy with the keep, and they get the one-timer to Pastrnak, but he couldn't get much on it. Husso made the save. Now it's Marchand in tight. McAvoy in the slot. That one stopped in front. Rebound comes loose out to the line. 45 seconds left on the clock. No stick for Husso. Puck skips the stick of Marchand.
Great play
from Larkin.
Great play by Sider. He grabbed the stick and he gave it to the goaltender.
Dumped back in with 33 on the clock. Wallman up the boards. Comes to Kopp. Kopp to Suter. Pastrnak can't keep it in. Here's Kopp to the empty net. The Red Wings are going to hang on here and take down the Boston Bruins.
That right pad save by Ville Husso was outstanding. On the right side, watch the right pad slide out there. This was labeled.
They put themselves on a short list. One of 10 teams to beat the Boston Bruins in regulation this season. It's a 5-3 win at home for the Red Wings.
Hey, buddy.
Oh, an impressive victory for Detroit. They split the weekend series, both home teams winning in their two-game set with the Boston Bruins.
Yeah, I'm pretty emotional weekend, certainly, for Tyler Bertuzzi and his good buddy Dylan Larkin. Mo Sider scores a beautiful shorthanded goal. He got cut on the chin yesterday for several stitches, and this was an entertaining back-to-back home-and-home series between two original six teams. And Ville Husso, a big story in this one. He was outstanding.
He finishes with 31 saves in the game and his 25th win of the year.